You can contribute to the show by calling or texting 412-701-4323 and letting me know what content you want to hear on future episodes. Your feedback helps support the 7-Minute Leadership Podcast and provides listeners around the world with the topics that are relevant to you, our listeners. That's 412-701-4323. Thanks for supporting Paul Falavolito Podcasts. I'm giving away one of my policies next on the 7-Minute Leadership Podcast.
Helping leaders motivate their people to a higher level of performance through strong human relations, team building, and goal achieving. This is the 7-Minute Leadership Podcast with your host, Paul Falavolito.
What's up, everyone? Welcome to the 7-Minute Leadership Podcast. It's episode 95, and as we inch closer to the 100th episode, I've decided to do something a little different. Today, I'm going to give away one of my policies, and it's not just any old HR policy. This is one that is very near and dear to my heart, right? Seriously, who says that about policies? Well, I do. Because policies mean a lot, especially the ones that you create, or how about the very first policy that you ever created? Well, that's what I want to talk about today, and this will tie in nicely with episode 94 in the whole accountability discussion that we just had. So 16 years ago, I created a policy that addressed a large gap that exists in the EMS business model. And the cool thing about this policy is that you can take it and scale it to your business model or your company. But in the EMS world, when an EMT or paramedic goes to school, they only learn one thing, and that's patient care. And this is why they are crazy skilled and are amazing at what they do. However, when you enter the EMS business world, and if you want to be successful, you can't only rely on patient care as your only skill set. That's why I created a program and a policy called the Care For Program. And what the Care For Program does is cover four areas: patient care, customer care, self-care, and organization care. And on day one for all of my new hires, the very first document and discussion they get from me is the Care For Program. This is their personal and professional commitment to excellence and accountability in these four areas. For patient care, I explained to them that their commitment is that they're going to operate and abide by our State Department of Health basic life support or advanced life support protocols and not operated outside of their scope of practice. That's the easy one because that's what they're taught in school. The remaining three are not taught in EMT or paramedic school. So for customer care, I explained to them that in addition to having patients, we also have customers. And our customers can be the residents that join our ambulance membership program, someone that shows up for a flu shot or a blood pressure check, or someone that stops by the station to ask a question. Their commitment in this area is to ensure that they treat our customers well. And the example that I love to use is the McDonald's and Chick-fil-A comparison. Now, I'm a huge McDonald's and Chick-fil-A lover, so I'm not bashing either of them, but there's a gigantic difference in customer service depending on which restaurant you go to. Chick-fil-A is better at customer service, and if you visit both restaurants, you know what I'm talking about. So I explained to my employees that in the moment when you have to take care of one of our customers, be Chick-fil-A. Now, self-care is a little unique because what the public might not be aware of is the fact that a huge percentage of EMS personnel all work a second EMS job, and oftentimes that means working another 24-hour shift during the week in addition to their full-time EMS job. Working back-to-back 24-hour shifts at two different ambulance services is very common in the EMS world. So how I explain self-care is that I understand the need to work additional shifts, but if working for me is their full-time job, then I expect them to show up with some gas in their tank. I need them to eat well, stay hydrated, and sleep well. I need them to take care of themselves because I need them to be the very best version of themselves that they can be. It also means they're expected to comply with socially accepted grooming and hygiene standards as well. And the last part of the Care For program is organization care. And all of my employees know this. We take care of our own. In return, we expect our employees to take care of our company, and that means treating our vehicles and equipment as if they were their own. So there it is. That's the Care For program and the very first program and policy I created 16 years ago for my staff. And like I said, you can take out patient care and use the other three, or change the patient care one to something that's more relevant to your company. But this is a great way from day one to set expectations and begin the accountability commitment. Helping each other is what this is all about. It's why I create content, and it's why you listen. At the beginning of this episode, I asked you for your feedback and how I can help you more. In return, I can continue to share episodes similar to this because in today's business world, we all have unique little ways of doing things, and these just might help someone else be the very best version of themselves that they can be. This has been the 7-Minute Leadership Podcast, and I thank you for listening.
For more Paul Falavolito podcasts, visit paulfalavolito.com.